Hi friends, welcome back to my new video. Today we are going to discuss about the control of engine emission by using catalytic converter. Basically, I will recommend you to go through my previous lecture where I have discussed about engine emission, what are the emissions coming out of engine. The link is provided here. Okay, now in the previous lecture we have discussed that the fuel is nothing but hydrocarbon. The content of fuel, it may be diesel or petrol, basically it contains a hydrocarbon. This hydrocarbon react with the air which contains oxygen and nitrogen. After reaction of these two, what are the products formed? These products are H2O, CO2 and N2. These are the expected product. So hydrogen react with the oxygen forms H2O. Carbon react with the oxygen forms CO2 and N2 is the inert gas, and that will not react at the lower temperature and it will come as it is. This is the expected reaction, and if this reaction happens, we don't consider that the pollution is too much serious. But in actual case, this will not happen. In addition to this, some of the other pollutant also added, like CO, HCI and NOx. In the previous video, we have discussed about why CO will form. CO will form because of incomplete combustion of carbon. Why there is incomplete combustion of carbon? That also I have discussed in the previous videos. There will be HC at the exit of the engine. And why this HC has been introduced? Because of unburned fuel. Now, why there is unburned fuel at the exit of the engine? That also we have discussed in last lecture. And last is the nitrogen oxide, which is produced at the high temperature. Now, these three are considered to be serious pollutant, and that has to be controlled. Whereas this H2O, CO2 and N2, which are shown by the green color, it is not that much serious, but we have to control CO, HC and NOx. Okay, now let's discuss how it can be controlled. Okay, now for controlling this, we are going to discuss how catalytic converter works. In the catalytic converter, currently I am showing the construction of this. The catalytic converter location, if you observe, this located after the engine, means exhaust pipeline of the engine is connected to catalytic converter to this particular end. So this end is connected to engine exhaust system, whereas this end is going to the silencer of the vehicle, from which the gases goes to the atmosphere. Okay, so this will be connected to the engine, and this will be going to the atmosphere. In between, we are having a pipeline, and in the pipeline, there is a two ceramic blocks. This yellow color, whatever I have shown, that is a two ceramic blocks. This is first ceramic block, and it is like honeycomb structure. This we have shown already that there is a honeycomb kind of the structure, and in this honeycomb kind of the structure, what we have provided is the platinum and rhodium will be pasted here. Okay, the platinum and rhodium, which will be in the form of paste, and that paste is provided in this particular ceramic block number 1. Okay, similar kind of structure is available in ceramic block number 2. This is ceramic block number 2. In the ceramic block number 2, what are the materials we have provided? That is platinum and palladium. So you can see here, the first ceramic block, platinum and rhodium. Next ceramic block, platinum and palladium. This is again pasted on the honeycomb kind of the structure. So these two, this first is platinum and rhodium, that will act as a catalyst for the reducing pollution. At the same time, platinum and palladium, this is also acting as a catalyst for the control of the pollution. Now let us see how these control the pollution. Generally, controlling the pollution means what? In the previous slide, we have seen that there is a CO, HCI and NOx. Converting these elements, CO, HCI and NOx, into expected pollution. What is expected pollution? Expected pollution is H2O, CO2 and N2. So converting this into this is called as pollution control, and that will happen in the catalytic converter. Let's see how it will happen. Initially, as I told you, this is connected to the engine. So this from exhaust gases are coming from an engine to this one. So I'll show you some of the animation. So here, let's consider that from the engine, what we are getting inlet as NOx, CO and HC. NOx is formed at high temperature, CO is unburned form of the carbon, and HC is the fuel, unburned fuel, that will enter into the system. After entering into the system of catalytic converter, this will go to the first ceramic block, which is where what we are having palladium and platinum and the rhodium. Platinum and the rhodium is present in the honeycomb structure when NOx comes in a contact with the platinum and rhodium, there is a chemical reaction. Chemical reaction occurs for only NOx, whereas CO and HC will remain as it is. There will not be any reaction for these two, CO and HC. The reaction will happen only for the NOx. Now, NOx react with the platinum and rhodium, which is catalytic, which is the catalyst, and the NOx will convert into N2 and O2. The reaction is given here. As the gas enters, the inside molecules are first react. The catalyst causes the oxides of nitrogen to reform into nitrogen and oxygen respectively. So this is oxides of nitrogen, which is NOx. So this is NOx. The NOx will react with the catalyst and forms oxygen and nitrogen. So only NOx will be reacting, whereas other, that is CO and HC, CO and HC will remain as it is. Okay, now in the ceramic block, first we have discussed about only NOx, whereas the other terms will be as it is. So at the exit of the ceramic block number one, what we are having, the NOx, this NOx has got converted into N2 and O2, whereas CO as it is came outside, whereas HC also came outside. So we have solved the problem of NOx. Still there is a problem of CO and HC. Let's discuss how CO and HC will get removed. Okay, now this particular term, this particular gas is, that is N2, O2, CO and HC will enter into ceramic block number 2. This is the ceramic block number 2, and there the reaction will happen with platinum and palladium. So let's see what happens here. Now when these gases enter into ceramic block number 2, there will be reaction, as I am showing the animation there. Okay, so reaction will occur. Reaction of what? CO with platinum and palladium, HC with platinum and palladium. And what output will get? The output will be like this. First of all, I will discuss about CO. What happened with the CO? Here the carbon monoxide react with the oxygen molecule to form carbon dioxide. Means CO react with oxygen and forms CO2. So this CO react with oxygen. Oxygen is already present, which is entering into the system. Oxygen is entering and CO is entering. Both will react, and for the reaction, what will help? The platinum and palladium, it will act as a catalyst. What is catalyst? It will do the reaction faster, and that's why the reaction will occur, and what will get output as a CO2. Means CO has got converted into CO2, that we have seen it. So question of CO has finished now, that CO has converted into CO2. Then next, what happened with HC? Now what happened with HC, that we have explained here, that the unburned hydrocarbon also react with oxygen to form water and carbon dioxide. So here the water and carbon dioxide will form from the HC. So this is HC, which will enter into ceramic block number 2, this ceramic block number 2, and that will react with the oxygen. For having a proper reaction, the catalyst will help, that is platinum and palladium, both will help. And what output will get? Output will get as a water. Output will get as water, because hydrogen react with oxygen forms H2O. Next molecule is what? Carbon. Carbon react with oxygen and forms what? Carbon dioxide. So from HC, from this particular HC, what is from is H2O and CO2. From CO, what we have found? We have found CO2, whereas N2 as it is will get output, and where O2 will go? O2 will help for these two molecules to react and forms the expected outcome. So what we have got as the outcome, the N2 as it is passed outlet. So this is N2 as it is. This CO has formed CO2, HC has formed H2O. These are called as expected molecules. These are called as expected pollutants rather. So these expected pollutants are available at the exit now. Okay, and this will carry to the exit pipeline. So now you can see that what was at the inlet. At the inlet we were having NOx, CO and HC, and in ceramic block number 1, NOx get reacted and forms N2 and O2, and in ceramic block number 2, CO and HC gets reacted and forms N2, CO2 and H2. Like this, the catalytic converter converts NOx, CO, HC into N2, CO2 and H2. This is all about working of a catalytic converter. Thank you very much for listening.